Alright, what's going on, guys? This is MJ from Dynamic Render Labs, and this is the fifth chapter of my D5 Reality course, which is about camera tracking and render matching in D5 Render. In this video, we learn how to match the color of our video output from D5 Render to the color of our drone footage in After Effects. If you don't know After Effects, don't worry, I try to explain everything. If you want to know more about this course, please watch the introduction in the playlist, and if you learn anything new from this video, please like, comment, and subscribe. Let's get it started. Color matching can be very challenging. It's not an easy step with one clear formula, but if you have already tried to color match two photos before, it's a piece of cake. But if you're new to this,
practice makes perfect.
It's totally doable. And now, in this video, I'll share what I do for my footages.
You know, I'm something of a scientist myself.
And hopefully, it helps you. First, we need to make these three layers one layer, meaning the render, the duplicate, and the mask. We don't want to apply the color effects on them separately, so I select the first one, hold shift, and select last one. Right click and choose pre-compose. Use these settings and press OK. If you want to edit masks again, we can just double click and go to the pre-compose. It will open here, and any edit we do here will be applied automatically to the main video. In case you wanted the main video or the drone footage here, just copy it from main composition using Ctrl C and paste it here using Ctrl V. But remember to remove or hide it using this eye icon here before going back. Now, we're gonna start adding our effects, which in this video is just one Lumetri color. First, go to effects and presets window here. If it's not here, then go to window and check effects and presets. Now type Lumetri and drag Lumetri color to your pre-composed clip here. Now for this, I always start at highlights and shadows. I believe they are very good to start. To understand what I'm doing with them better, right click on the composition and add a solid. And make the color gray. Now go in the blending mode and make it color. This way, composition becomes black and white. Again, if you don't see blending mode, press on toggle switches modes here. Now with the colors gone from our video, we can analyze it and see what's not working with our added video. And for sure, one is these trees. I mean, compare them to the trees here. The other issue is the shadows. Look how dark are these and how bright. Let's start with highlights and shadows. Select your pre-comp, go to basic correction here. Now we can see bunch of settings. First, I lower the highlights. Look at this. They are already starting to match. Now let's do it with the shadows as well. I'm going to lower the shadows until the shadows next to house match the rest of the footage. And if you notice, this will ruin our highlights, but it's okay. Match the shadows first. As you can see, this is much better now. So let's go to highlights and increase it. Look at it. It looks better now. Let's remove the gray color we made for black and white, and there we go. As you can see, it's pretty interesting. We basically changed two parameters and they're already matching pretty good. But this may not happen in every project, so let's take a more professional approach. Let's change one rule. Let's just ignore green.
Oh, you don't like green? Is that it? You don't like green?
Why? Because we can change them separately. So I can move the highlights back to zero. Or no, even make it less and instead increase the exposure to make it lively. Change the contrast, whites, blacks. Play with these settings and make sure you look at anything but the greens. You can also open this creative part here and work with vibrance as well. If you think depth of colors are different, saturation also works like vibrance, but it's very strong and not subtle at all. If you want to reset anything, right click and choose reset. Once I feel satisfied with the result, it's time to move on green.
It's not easy being green.
Go here in HSL secondary, go to keys and choose set color. Select one of your greens. Now check show mask and open HSL sliders. As you can see, parts of our greens are now selected, but we should select all greens. We have control over hue, saturation, and lightness, and each of these has three types of controls. Let's go to saturation, which is for different levels of color depth. First, we can click and hold at this white middle one to choose what part of the spectrum we want. We can expand the selection using the top triangle, and we can blend it out with bottom. You can even uncheck it to select all. But as you can see, this way we choose parts of the house as well, which we don't need. So let's press Ctrl Z to go back to sliders. Lightness works on darks and lights.
I uncheck it so it selects everything, but apparently it also selects the white side of the house as well. So I press Ctrl Z and adjust it manually for the best result.
Now let's go to the hue, which we select colors now. You have to play with these three to get as much as greens as you can, especially the bright parts. You don't actually have to worry about dark areas that much. One thing you should consider here, it may show rest of the render too, the areas we hide behind our mask. But don't get distracted by them. Again, just pay attention to what we need. For me, the important part are these trees, and it's possible it would select some other areas as well. Just make sure it won't select the main colors of the building. Once the selection is over, we have refine option here. So increase denoise to avoid small spots, and also increase blur to avoid sharp masks. I'll go about one or two. After the adjustment, uncheck show mask, and now we can add correction here. There are some general corrections like temperature, which can help matching greens in our renders to the source. We can also use contrast to further adjust the darkness in the shadows. But the main and the most powerful option is the color wheels here. We can adjust some stuff here, like slightly move toward yellow. And of course, don't go all the way to the sides. It will increase saturation to something uncomfortable. Just stick to middle. If you want to reset it, just double click on it. The slider here works on the contrast too. You can double click to reset it as well. But I would suggest going to the three wheels here so you can change shadows and highlights as well.
Take your time and play around with these parameters. For colors, always try to stay close to the middle to avoid high saturation. And don't forget to use the sliders, which can be very helpful for shadows and highlights. Eventually, you come across the combination that works best for your footage. Remember, practice makes perfect. After that, I play around with saturation to further adjust it. At some point, I feel the trunk of this tree doesn't look good, so I double click on Precomp and go to fix it. But as you can see, I can't see the masks. This usually happens when you go to another comp or turn off layer control by mistake. So I turn it on by going to view and turning on layer controls. And now I can adjust the masks. By the way, if you wanted to separate more colors like green to adjust them individually, just add another Lumetri color and you can do it. I noticed there's even another trunk here toward the end, so I tried to fix it too. A few back and forth later, and that's fixed. Seriously guys, if we had better masking, all this could be avoidable. So again, please vote for the object mask feature in D5 forum. If you haven't already voted, check the link in description.
It seems we have matched the general color, and it's time to color grade. Color grading adds an extra touch for blending, which can help a lot. With color grading, we adjust our footage and render together, considering them one.
You're gonna have to treat me the same way you treated Jan.
So it would make them act to filters together, which will make the result much better. Metaphorically speaking, by color matching, we managed to blend our zucchini inside a bunch of cucumbers. Now, by color grading, we're going to dice them all together, so no one would notice the difference. Unless, well, they eat it, of course. But hopefully no one eats our footage. Wasn't that a good example?
That's not what a metaphor is.
Now, color grading has different levels. There are people making money on just color grading. It has many layers, and you can go into it and master it all you want.
It's a brave new world.
But for now, we're gonna just do some small tweaks.
That's it?
To start, first, right-click on the composition here and add an adjustment layer. Any filters being applied here will apply to all the layers beneath. Again, we add the luminosity color here, go to basic correction, and play around with numbers. What I'd like to do is to reduce highlights and shadows first, then add exposure. You can actually do the other way around too. For example, reduce exposure, then increase highlights and shadows. It's interesting the effect they create. Next, I would adjust white value a bit and increase black value for a small amount. This way, blacks are a little stylish. As you can see, this adjustment would make the colors pop up a bit. Next, I open Creative here and try to style it a bit. You can also play around to find what works for you. For me, add a bit faded fill and also increase vibrance. For a unique color style, try adding a lookup table profile. If you go to Look here, there are many looks you can choose, which can change how the video looks. I like using a free LUT called Cobalt 1 from Sparkle Stock. Again, link in the description. It has a cool look, though intense, so I dial it back to around 40% in intensity for a subtle effect without removing the main vibe. Lastly, I go to Split Toning here, give a slight shadow tint in the blue spectrum, and move highlight tint to orange spectrum. This is a famous orange-blue tint that usually have positive effects in the boot. Although I reduced the tint balance so to make it warm. And this looks great. If you want, you can go here and also add vignette. I increase amount, adjust midpoint, roughness, and feather to give more focus in the middle of the screen. Looks fantastic. And now we're done. But let's go with one more thing. Adding this slight grain effect can help blending the render and the footage. You can go here and type noise, and then add some noise. It depends on your taste, but I'll go 2 to 5%. You can also make it monotone or color as well. If you want to be more stylish, you can use custom grains as well. I have this pack of 5 Shutterstock grains with a link in the description, which can add different vibes. You can use a normal 35mm. Import, add it to the composition, go to the mode and choose overlay. The one I chose is very subtle, so you may not see it clearly here, but it's there. You can also change opacity here to adjust the strength. Of course, you can also change opacity by pressing T on keyboard. There's a good chance the overlay time is shorter, but it's okay. Right-click, go to Time, enable Time Remapping. Hold Alt, right-click on the stopwatch here, and type Loop Out with parentheses in here. Now you can drag this for the entire clip. That's it.
It's finally over.
Now let's see where we started. This was the drone. We added the house, matched color,
and finally did a color grade and added some grain. I like it.
Perfection.
You can finally export it by going to File, Export, Add to Render Queue. For output mode, you can choose any format, but H.264 is very good with lower sizes, and you can increase quality by going to Format option and adjust target bitrate. 15 is basic social media output. Typical drone footage bitrate is 150 to 200, and the basic D5 output is around 300 to 500, sometimes even more. You can usually check this by right-clicking on your video file, going to Properties, Details, then checking Total Bitrate. You can only be as strong as the weakest total bitrate between your drone footage and render. But remember, social media only uses 50 to 30, but the larger you use, the heavier the file, the longer the render time, and the better quality when you watch it directly. You can also resize it to 1080p or 2K if you want. Lastly, specify output location and name, and finally, set to render. There we go. This sums up the last essential episode to camera tracking course. But I will have other videos in the playlist. You can check them as well, especially my guide for making cool Instagram reels and TikToks. And you want to make sure you watch the video about photo merging too. It's very useful. If you're facing problems with color matching, maybe send your files to me. I can make more tutorials on color grading in different scenarios and can be more helpful.
Well, I want to help you.
If you had any questions, the comment section is available for each step of the course. Just ask away your questions and I'll try to help. Thanks for choosing my tutorial and watching it. If you enjoy, please like, subscribe, buy me a coffee, send me Bitcoin, anything. Have fun. I'll see you in the next one.